I'm sitting here in Superior, Arizona. I'll tell you, so you can take a look at what you're seeing of me right here. Hotel Magma. Mountains up here. Apache Leap. Right around there. Small town, Arizona. Could be a small town anywhere, right? You know, a lot of the small towns in the Midwest, you know, the struggle when industry leaves or stays or leaves. And you know, there's a point where you look at your own life and you're like, man, what journey have I been on? What do I need to do, you know? And sitting on this corner across from the Magma, you know, I think it was Miguel was the gentleman that put that back together, and he had such dreams and hopes that this place was going to kind of rise this town from the dead. And, you know, it shut down. I don't know if it's permanent or not, you know, and I'm sitting in front of the other pharmacy, which is a lot of cool history in this town. And it's like anywhere, though, in any journey that any of us take. You know, I was down at the the Circle K here in Superior, and I'm not trying to badmouth it, but that place was horrible. And you know, the bathrooms were destroyed and the pumps were filthy, like dirty, filthy. And you're just like, you know, doesn't anybody not see that? You know, how could you have a Circle K that looked like that? You know, and all the graffiti in the bathroom made you think that you were in the middle of Boston or somewhere. No offense to Boston, I guess, but I guess it was. But you know, it's like you don't expect that. You know, you expect that small towns stay clean. Now, Superior, if you look down the street, ain't a lot going on this morning, but you know, it's not dirty. You know, it's actually relatively clean. They were cleaning this morning. That's one thing we noticed about the downtown area. But you wonder, you know, all this journey that's been through here, all the people and all the history, and you know, does people really care about keeping this alive or not? You know, I definitely on my channel have not done something right, whether I'm a horrible storyteller or whatever that might be, to try to help keep these towns alive. But you know, it's frustrating. And, you know, it's just part of the journey, man. As you get older, too, you're like looking for what's the next thing. What do you do? You know, where do you go? What do you experience or see? And it really, you know, it's today. I didn't even want to get up. We're going to Globe today and get some really cool history. But, I mean, does anybody give a shit about history, really? Evidently, I mean, you know, maybe not, maybe, or maybe it's just the way that I tell it, or the way that I'm so fired up about history that, you know, it's really a cool thing to me. But maybe it isn't to everybody. You don't want to say everybody, enough of an audience that the people want to see it. And I'm just sitting here waiting for Dean. Hopefully it'll be a cool journey today. But, you know, today I almost called him, you know, but, you know, if you tell somebody you're going to be there, then you'd be there. You know, that's the way it's supposed to be. And I look at this town, you know, like a lot of small towns, again, you know, and the industry runs out. And then what do they got left, man? The only thing they really got left is their history. And if that's not cool enough to bring it in, or they can't figure a way to do it, man, that's a tough deal. I believe you can bring these towns back, but maybe I'm the one that's the fool. Maybe I'm the one that's the dummy. Maybe history is really dead. Maybe history is today, and then today your history is done. And after that, does anybody really care about yesterday? You know, I want to think so, but it doesn't feel like it to me right now. So here I am in a small town just contemplating the journey that I've been on. You know, has my life been successful? Has it not? You know, you start thinking about these things when you get to that age that you're like, wow, what is this really all about? And, you know, I'm gonna take a walk down this, get up, and this is where I was sitting, the pharmacy. Now, what a beautiful building he put together. It really is just absolutely unbelievable. And there's a few people scurrying around this morning. You know, I hope they make it. You know, I hope whatever they're doing, it works out, you know. I do hope. I didn't even know, I didn't check my microphone even today. Yes, it is working. You already knew that, but I didn't. You know, look at this place. If you go down through here, how cool is that? I mean, there's got to be some You know, maybe they just need the more people to come in here. Maybe when the snowbirds get here. And if you don't know, a snowbird is somebody that comes from another area, usually a colder climate, that spends the winter with us because it's snowing where they're at. You know, I figured most people knew that, but you never know. I mean, if you walk through here, it's pretty cool. I will say that I feel pretty safe, you know. I feel pretty safe here. It's not like, you know, and out here in Arizona, I don't know if you're familiar with this, but we all carry guns. That's not a myth. So when you do stuff, stupid stuff on the highway, I'll tighten that up. And then let's get this coffee, the Circle K coffee, and the dirtiest Circle K in the United States of America. You know, I've never done this, but it's kind of cool just walking down here. You know, potential. Man, there is potential here. I know there is. You know, there's people staying fit over there still, you know. Come down here. Small town Arizona, man. They're mostly mining towns. That's what drew most of the people into Arizona. And just taking a stroll. Thinking about my history, you know, the world's history. Look at this store here. How cool is this? I mean, these are neat places, but you got to have people, you know, you've got people coming in, got to be able to survive. It's like an ice cream shop there. I'd like to have this little building right here. I don't know why, but I would. So, Martinez Barber Shop. Man, that's an old sign, but you know what? That's kind of what made these places cool. It's like a studio right now. People working. I think we got some free workers from the state. I mean, they've got this place looking pretty cool. I mean, they're working on it. They're trying to make it nice. That's a pretty nice little park right there. I said, I think we got some free workers of the state here as well, which is good. You know, not too many streets you can walk right down the middle of the street. Walk through here. I'd read somewhere that this place had the most bars per square foot or whatever, per distance. I'd read that somewhere, and I don't know if that's true history or not. I don't remember, you know, where I read it. I couldn't find it again, so. But I mean, these places would have been wild. I mean, it's a tough deal. But what a backdrop. Where the hell are you going to find a town like this? Especially if it's not in Colorado. I really have always liked this town. Hope my GoPro don't catch on fire. It is a GoPro. They're known to do that. Sun's coming out, getting warm. What a beautiful morning it's been so far. That's odd when you're in August in this state. I mean, you can tell they had it going on at one time. They definitely had it going on. Probably now mainly retired people. It's kind of cool that there's all these cars here. I think they're at the gym working out, which is kind of cool. I'm kind of enjoying that. I mean, it's kind of an awesome deal. Coffee shop. Too bad we didn't get in there. I guess it'd have to be open, but they got to have customers to be open. So, you know, just looking down the road. People still staying fit. I mean, they're still trying to stay in shape. I mean, we're not walking the whole area. I just love old buildings, though. One thing about me and my brother-in-law, Darren, we seem to have this love for history and love for these old towns. I mean, I could wake up and look at that every day. I hate to say that, but I could. You know, I could look at that peak every day. I'm going to go see if these guys are still, the door's open. I'm going to see if they're open. It looked like they were closed. Maybe they're not. I'll shut this up. You know, the hotel is open. And take a look around here. Now, what a great weekend you could have. I mean, there's so many different things. Look how beautiful this place is. I mean, this place is gorgeous. I mean, the time and energy they put into this place to bring it back, you know, is, you know, can only use our support. Because I tell you, this is beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. She said it was open Friday, Saturday, Sunday, I guess. So it is open. And all this is open is just, you know, it's got to be tough, though. I'm not going to lie. It's got to be tough to get people down here. But you know what? Maybe that's my journey in life is to bring back small town America. Maybe that's my journey in life. Everybody's got a journey. Maybe that's going to be mine is to try to bring these places back or do what I can do to bring them back. And again, this is where they used to have the underground tunnel that went from here to there. And then they used to have a room in the bottom of the road is where they used to drink during Prohibition. You know, you're not going to stop people from drinking. There's no doubt about that. And then back here was the old jail. Church on the corner. You know, everybody would have known everybody's business, which is good and bad. I mean, you know, it is good and bad. That, if I remember correctly, right there is the old jail. Right here. Look how beautiful this is. I mean, he does such a beautiful job. It's a shame that we don't come and support things like this. I mean, guys like him that can do it are not going to see it be feasible. If I'm gonna go over here, if we can't get the support, never really looked in here. Yeah. Yeah. There's an old pioneer right there. That looks like bars. Oh, I think he's got this thing set up back like it used to be. Those definitely look like bars back there. So the old jail might be like the old jail used to be. He was really good about trying to put this. Yeah, there's the bars. So that is the old jail right there. Again, if you woke up in those rooms right there and you looked out, you know, there's really not a bad, I think almost all of them have views of the outdoors. So take a look at this. You know, this town's still supported by mining. You know, up over that ridge is the largest copper mine in the world. Right there. In the world, and there's a whole nother story about that as well. But you know what? Sometimes history can't get in the middle of progress. You got to make money. If you don't make money, I mean, history can't stand in the way. There's the Arizona Timeless Tourist. Let's go see what he's doing. I love that building up there. Look at that. There's Arizona Timeless Tourist in Superior, Arizona. What are you doing, Arizona Timeless Tourist?
I came down here. I think I couldn't make the turn, so I turned
Well, it's open. I just talked to the gal inside. It's open, so the journey is good. We're back.
I might come back and look in here when we get back.
It's beautiful. They close at 6. And if you're at 6, they close at 6, and that's it.
Is that open?
Yeah, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Yeah.
Sense.